PLC Network here at CES 2018, and we are at the Fibaro booth. And this is Rich with Fibaro, and he's got some new items here. In the past, we've gone over some things like the cool the swipe and the button, the universal button that can do just about anything you want, literally.
Yep.
Just
absolutely.
Make up a scene, bunch of button presses, press it down, hold it down. It, you know, it's an amazing button, especially if you get a red one and put it anywhere. It's like that big red button you just kind of intimidate people with. But there's something new now. What do you have that's new?
So this year, we took that very popular button that we talked about last year, which was in Z-Wave, and now we're introducing it in HomeKit. So it's something that we've had a lot of questions about, a lot of people looking for, you know, some simplicity in HomeKit devices in that ecosystem. You know, obviously we have voice, but there's also a lot of times where people want to be able to do something, you know, bedside, rolling out of the bed, you know, clicking a button, you're turning on your good morning scene, or going to bed, your good night scene. Some really popular use cases. Kids love to use the button, turning on LED lighting. You know, there's a lot of great different LED, you know, colored lighting that you can use. You could even close your door, roll down the shade. So the button adds a lot of versatility to group a bunch of things together and make it very simple.
And now you have the option in both Z-Wave and HomeKit as well for Apple.
Yep.
And
absolutely.
You also, you have something for smart plugs as well now.
So back to the Z-Wave side, we're adding this new Z-Wave wall plug. And as you can see, it's got a blue glow to it. So that's by design. The plug itself monitors energy. So when you plug something into it, it'll actually show how much power is being consumed. So if you had an iron plugged into that, it would actually show that it's like really bright red. And what's really unique about this, so not only is the form factor really small, but we've added a micro a USB charger. So when you put this, like for example, by your bedside and you plug it in, you could actually still charge your phone. You've got the ability to control your lighting, and you're still, you know, using the phone being charged. Additionally, it also has power consumption at the USB charger itself.
As well. So, and what you were saying earlier, you actually, in your own personal setup, you have it set so you have a scene that monitors for when you have wattage change, and when you pick up your phone, when it's, you know, it goes from charging or being completely charged to turning on that screen, and you see that extra consumption, that kind of wakes up your morning scene.
Yep. So, absolutely. So, when the phone is completely charged, it's using about, you know, 4 watts. And when I pick that phone up in the morning, the screen going on changes that power to about like 6 watts. So that is my trigger to actually start my good morning scene. So I'm not having to touch a button. I'm not having to say anything. It's just a simple fact of picking that phone up and going to unplug it, that is changing that wattage, and then that sets my good morning scene. So having that energy monitoring built into a lot of our products really gives that ability to have extra sensors if you want to look at it that way.
Perfect. Now, you actually have one other item, too. It's not available in the United States yet, but it's something that you're rolling out to Europe and maybe the U.S. someday.
Yeah.
Let's go take a look at that.
Yeah, sure. Let's go.
All right. So what we're standing in front of here, this is a doorbell, intercom doorbell?
An intercom doorbell.
Oh, so what all does this do?
So this intercom doorbell actually has, so besides it being an actual doorbell where you can ring and call to somebody, it actually has a PIN code. These numbers here will actually... gives you the ability to enter a PIN code. So you can give somebody a temporary code like 5436. The person can come in here and spin it. It's almost like a lock, and you enter it, and then that would unlock the door. So you have the ability to give somebody like a housekeeper a temporary PIN code. You can actually see when that PIN code was used. And it's got a dual relay too. So not only can it unlock a smart lock, but if you have like a relay, so it's got a double relay out, so you could do anything like on a gate or something. You could actually use the buzzer and actually unlock it as well. The camera itself on it is 180 degree 4K video. It's got also sound. In the future, we'll look to put voice biometrics into it as well. It's got Bluetooth as well, so Bluetooth enables the homeowner to sync it with their phone, so when they're walking up, it could automatically unlock the door and even set a scene. So you can, that person that's walking up, whether it's me or somebody else in my home, I like things certain way when I walk in the house, by the phone unlocking the lock itself, it starts a scene in motion.
What's really cool is a lot of the doorbells, they don't offer the 4K video.
Right.
Everything's been pretty much 1080. That's like the newest thing for a lot of those.
Sure.
This takes it much further then.
Yeah.
And on top of that, it's heated as well.
Yeah, so it's heated for cold climates, since you have to do the spinning, that you can, so it's not going to freeze over.
That's perfect. So Minnesota, it'll work out just fine.
Absolutely.
Or Canada or anywhere else that gets really, really cold. So this is Europe. This is releasing into Europe soon.
It's releasing right now.
It's
started about a week ago in Europe.
Okay. And then hopefully someday we might be able to see it in America too.
Yep. Hopefully.
Perfect. Well, Rich, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And we look forward, as always, to see what else that Fibaro comes out with. And we'll stay in touch.
Yeah. Thank you for coming by. Thank you for visiting.
Absolutely.
If you want to stay on top of all the latest and greatest and or at least the gadgets we cover, remember to subscribe right here. Subscription button. Click it. You're going to want to. There's lots of videos, interviews, previews, all sorts of stuff. Button. Click it.